Say you have a warehouse in Kolkata and you have to transfer the goods to stores in Mumbai, which means you have to create delivery challans for each of the stores in Mumbai. For every store, there would be a separate transportation charge, as the goods are going directly from the warehouse in Kolkata to the stores in Mumbai. This results in huge transportation charges. Now you could bring down the transportation charges by using the transit via option in Genesis. In this tutorial, we would be looking into the transit via concept. So what is transit via? Transit via is nothing but transferring the goods from the source site via a site or a hub to the destination site. We set up a transit via site in the destination location, which in our case is Mumbai. So at first, all the goods in the Kolkata warehouse are transferred to the transit via site in Mumbai. And then these goods are distributed to their respective stores from the transit via site. This results in comparatively less transportation charges. Now you would ask, how will Genesis capture the entire flow? Glad you asked. Let's look into it. Tagging the transit via site for the destination site. Tagging the transit via site in head office. In the customer form, click the organization owned sites button. You would see the list of sites the customer owns under the customer tab. Select the customer's site and mention the transit via site. To use the transit via option, check the strictly follow transit route checkbox for the site. Now the site is ready to receive the goods from the transit via site. Tagging the transit via site in POS. Open up the list of sites in retail management. Select the destination site and click Edit. In the Edit window, click the Replenishment tab. Add the site and scroll to the transit via field. Select the transit via site and check the strictly follow transit route checkbox for the site. Now the site is ready to receive the goods from the transit via site. The next step would be creating delivery challans for the destination sites. Now that we have the transit via site set up, we would create the delivery challans. To transfer the goods, we create delivery challans for the destination sites. As we will be transferring the goods to the transit via site, we create transfer routes or sales invoices for the transit via site using the delivery challans created. Step 3, creating transference. When the goods arrive at the transit via site, transfer in documents would be created against the transfer out documents. As the transferins are created, delivery challans would be generated for the destination site automatically. Step 4, transfer outs. So now transfer outs are created at the transit via site using the auto-generated delivery challans for the destination sites. You would see it listed while adding it to the transfer out. Finally, the goods are ready to be received at the stores or the other destination sites. In case of GRTs from the destination sites, the stores or other sites follow a similar process to return the goods via a transit via site. Transferins are created in the transit via site against the GRT. This automatically creates the delivery challans for the destination sites. Transfer routes are created using the auto-generated delivery challans for the destination site. And at the destination site, a transfer in is created against the transfer out. Please note that in case of an outright site, a sales return is created in the destination site instead of a transfer in. Well, now with the transit via option, you can save a lot. So what are you waiting for? Try out the new transit via concept and experience the difference. That was all about the transit via concept. To know more about the features in Genesys, subscribe to our channel and stay updated about us. Thank you.